There are a lot of weapons in The Last of Us Part 2, and you can pick up some earlier if you look in specific places. So in this video, I want to go over all the weapons in the game, the best upgrades in my opinion, and also how you can make sure that you do not miss them, so you also get the trophy. I will go in chronological order, mention no story spoilers, and use a weapon that you get very late in the story, actually in the early parts of the game, thanks to New Game Plus. There will be a new spoiler warning halfway through the video, I will let you know, but overall, no story spoilers and just a focus on the weapons. So let's get into it. A like on the video would be super appreciated, and let's go. You start the game with a semi-automatic pistol and a bolt-action rifle, and both will be pretty handy throughout the whole game. The pistol is amazing for stealth thanks to the skill to craft a silencer, and you can make that silencer better with the improved silencer skill, so then you can shoot 5 times before it breaks instead of 3. And 3 body shots are needed for regular human enemies, so totally go for the headshots to take them out in one. And I really recommend the weapon magazine upgrade for this weapon, because many enemies will have this gun, so you can refill your ammunition pretty fast, so the more you can carry, the better. The fire rate upgrade is also great, so you can faster take out approaching enemies when it's harder to aim for the head. The bolt action rifle is another weapon you will easily get ammo for from enemies, so capacity might be great to upgrade for this one too. But really the scope and the damage is a game changer for this one. By adding a scope, you suddenly make this a way more reliable sniper that is amazing for long range kills, although you will of course alert all the enemies inside. And the scope can also make aiming for the head way easier even when enemies are close. I would actually say that every upgrade for this weapon is nice, because stability will also help a lot with this weapon. Having some downtime between reloads hurts the weapon. It's just an overall great long range option, but it did focus more on the other weapons that you can get, like the bow. And the bow is unmissable. You get it at some point relatively early in the main story, and I will talk on the pistol you can get before that, and also the shotgun in a second. But now let's focus on the bow, because it keeps you quiet, so you can pick off enemies without them going after you. You want to focus on the headshots, because they are an insta-kill, but it takes some time to get used to the bow and to get those headshots. The rangefinder will help with that aim though, although I found the stability upgrade really nice too. Apart from it being a long range stealth weapon, it's also great that arrows can be picked up again after you do one of those headshots, and you can also craft them yourself if you have the dedicated resources. And by unlocking a skill, you can actually craft more arrows for the same amount of resources. You can also unlock a skill that lets you craft explosive arrows after finding the final magazine. And this is obviously not stealthy anymore, but super powerful, as you do not have to directly hit the enemies to have this be more effective. If the enemies are close to each other, they will instantly die, and you can craft new explosive arrows with the explosive resource, something I never really used anyways, because I did not find the trap that useful. Like, timing the trap mines and luring people into it never felt like something I wanted to do, although the stun bombs were pretty nice to instantly take out enemies with a melee strike. But yeah, then I prefer the explosive arrows. And there's also a final skill for that in the final skill line, so you can craft more explosive arrows with the same amount of resources. There's not much to say about the revolver in my opinion. A lot of enemies have it too, so that is actually nice. You can easily get ammo for it. But apart from that, it was my least used weapon. And I only upgraded the fire rate so far, and would go for damage after that, because in combat situations, when like grabbing this gun, it's actually nice to kill enemies as fast as possible. Yeah, overall, this was just a weapon that I would switch to when in combat, when that one still had a ton of ammunition, and then I would kill some enemies with it, but not much more. And you get this one when you actually reach Seattle, so pretty early in the game. And in Seattle downtown, you can find one of the best weapons in the game, the pump shotgun. Like, I think this is the first possible moment that you can actually get this weapon, and that is in the bank that you do not have to explore for the main story, but is over here in the downtown Seattle map. I already noticed this in a couple of videos, but overall, just clear the area of infected, use the code that you find on the piece of paper in front of the big vault door to open that big vault door. And I'm really curious, like, if you skip this and did not find the corpse with the shotgun, then where did you get this weapon, if at all? Like, there must be other ways to get it later on, right? So totally let me know in the comments of this video, or email me to input@geraptor.com and let me know where you got this weapon instead. No, but overall, this is of course amazing for close range. You will one-shot regular enemies if you are close enough, and otherwise you will stun them so you can easily finish them off with a follow-up shot. I also found that the capacity for this one was great to upgrade, just like stability. I just upgraded everything for this weapon as soon as possible because it was really my favorite option against many of the enemies. Near the very end of the game, Ellie gets another weapon. I won't show you where, I will just use it in early areas thanks to New Game Plus. And the weapon that I'm talking about is the silenced MP5. And this weapon feels like nothing you have used up to this point. Other weapons are rusty and not ideal, and this MP5 in comparison is amazing. Like, as the name suggests, there's always a silencer on it, so you can easily use it for stealth, but it's also nice in the regular firefights because of the insane rate of fire. There are no upgrades for this weapon, sadly, but it actually means that it's already great from the moment you get it. So it's really fun to replay the whole game in New Game Plus and have this weapon as an option in many of the encounters that happened way before the point that you actually got it. And now we move on to parts that happen later on in the story. So if you do not want to see what happens, then you are warned. Like, again, I will not show any story spoilers, just focus on the weapons, but still, I want to give you the warning. You still here? Okay then, because for Abby, we got an even bigger arsenal of weapons than for Ellie. She also starts out with a pistol, a military pistol, one that functions kind of similar to the one from Ellie. You can also put a silencer on it, but I never really used the pistol that much with Abby, also did not really upgrade it. And that was, I think, mostly because of the other weapon that you get at the start, the semi-auto rifle. That can carry a ton of ammo, and also the enemies were using it a lot, so you can easily restock. That's why also, in this case, the capacity upgrade is really nice for this gun. You can also add a scope to it, so it's easier to use from range and easier to aim. But I actually prefer the burst fire, because being able to switch to a 3-round burst is really amazing. Like, then you just have to pull the trigger once and easily take out an enemy. But you do run through your ammo, like, relatively fast. Although, again, the ammo is easy to come by. The weapon where you do not have a ton of ammo for, but that is very powerful, is the hunting pistol. You can find it in a safe pretty early in the Abbey section, in Seattle Day 1 and the On Foot chapter. I already highlighted how you can get it in my All Saves video, but if you haven't watched it yet, then I will just run through it quickly. So at one point you are stuck in the building with Mel, and then go to the train cars, but before you can do that, you want to squeeze yourself through the crack that you find on your right hand side. There you will find a safe that you can open with the combination 173807. And then you get this awesome gun. So I think that this is the earliest way to get this weapon, but I'm sure that you can also get it if you skip the safe, but later on. And then again, where did you find it if you skip the safe? Let me know in the comments, or email me to input@geraptor.com. And why I'm sure that you can get this gun through another way is because there is a skill that lets you craft ammo for it, which is super nice. It's like a sniper pistol that deals a ton of damage, but it also has some downtime after one shot. I totally recommend the scope for this one, so you can actually use it at a longer range. But yeah, overall, save this weapon for tougher enemies that can take a ton of damage. Damage you can, by the way, also enhance although I did not really do that until later on in the game. The weapon you can get for Abby after this is the double barrel shotgun, that just like the shotgun for Ellie, is awesome obviously for short range encounters. But apart from the two bullets that are in this magazine, compared to the six that Ellie got, there are some smaller differences, but really the big thing is that Abby can craft incendiary shells for this double barrel shotgun after unlocking a skill in the fourth skill line, and that's insanely powerful, causing enemies to burn. So I also showed in other videos already how you can get this gun, so I will keep it quick, but for as far as I know, the first location where you can get it is in the Hostile Territory chapter in Seattle Day 1. At one point you get to the wall painting and then have to advance, climb over the wall, then you are in this small shopping street, and then the final building on your left hand side is where you want to enter. Then go upstairs, take out the infected that you will see there, then jump to the other building, and now in that building we want to fall down, and then you can grab the shotgun behind the counter. And also with this one, I'm curious, like, if you got the weapon earlier or later, let me know in the comments or email me to input@jarepta.com. I don't think you can miss the crossbow on the ship, like you have to pass it for the main story, and they can immediately take out some infected with this weapon. And I love how they gave Abby a crossbow to still make it feel different to use as a stealth weapon compared to the bow, of course, for Ellie. Also here, you can grab your arrows again after getting a headshot, and that is great because you cannot actually craft the crossbow bolts, so you really need to find them or get the perfect kills. The scope is pretty nice, but overall I just did not upgrade the weapon that much because it was already that nice one-shot killing machine for stealth situations. The final weapon you can find with Abby is a returning one, the flamethrower. You can find it in Seattle Day 2 with Abby and in the Descent chapter. So at one point you have to find a mask for Lev, and after you completed that sequence, you can use a rope to go down, and now you are in a heavily infected area. But there is one room that is still intact, and via this room you have to go down for the main story. But what we want to do is actually squeeze through the door on your right hand side. Then walk over the bar to get to the other side, and there you will find the flamethrower. So again, it's missable, but I'm sure there will be another way to get it later on, so totally let me know in the comments down below. You cannot upgrade the flamethrower, but it's already pretty good, although I always think it's just fun to use weapons like this, but not really that convenient. But using it against infected is nice for sure, and of course the impact on human enemies can be awesome too. Subscribe for way more The Last of Us Part 2 coverage if you haven't already. A like on the video would be super appreciated. And again, I have a video up with all the saves in the game and more nice items you can find. You can watch it by clicking on the screen. For now, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye.